for you. You're not tired, are you? You don't want to go back to your tents. You don't want to go back to your campers. Not now. Not when the party's still happening. Not when we got a lot more rock and roll for you. Not when. I'm asking, what do you want to hear? Man, I think we'll do that one. I think we'll do that. Okay, this one comes from 1983. But you gotta see it! Don't wanna wait till you know me better! Let's just be glad for the time together! Now get your drink and baby take that! We'll be right back.
lips. There was a little bit of Kiss lick it up from Mr. Ron C. not a bad tune. Yeah, I think they still may be playing just a little bit. Still think they could be going on tours. You know, Metallica's not going to stop for quite a while. I tell you that now. Of course, it's always good to hear them guys, man. And they put on a hell of a show. Just like Madison Rising. Madison Rising, if y'all are in Texas, Madison Rising's down there for a whole fucking month. So, there's no excuse not to make a show. Seriously. I mean, you know, me, you being stationed in Fort Riley, Kansas at one point in time, having to drive 2 hours to go do something. If you're in the state, shit, it's well worth the trip. Guarantee that. So, anyway, looks like ISIS is being pushed out of a lot of places. I know they were being pushed out of Syria. Something that we talked about last week. That, you know, the news and everything was reporting from inside the country and talking to the militants that are actually there to protect the country, that, you know, they're starting to pull away from a lot of damn cities. So, you know, that's good on our side, because that way President Trump doesn't have to do what he did last time during the chemical attack, is put some rockets over there, because y'all want to piss off Russia. I mean, that's Russia's, like, right-hand man when it comes to their oil supply and stuff like that. So, you know, you got to... You know, gotta pick and choose your cards, right? And, you know, that, which is the same thing, China's pulling away from North Korea because of their idiotic fucking intentions of, wanting to shoot a missile. Well, we all know it's not gonna reach it here. We'll shoot it down before it gets here. But the simple fact that they would be dumb enough to push that button is, you know, still boggles and whatever with my mind. That to me, that's just stupid and retarded, and I don't think World War III would start. I think North Korea would be demolished, and everybody would move on about their way. Honestly, so. All right, well, looks like we got some breaking news coming through. Let's check this out. Holy crap.
If you're just joining us, we are covering a developing story. We go back now to Southern California, where a VH1 bus crashed just a short while ago, spilling more than 2,000 pounds of slut onto Interstate 5 near Palmdale. The bus was transporting contestants for the new VH1 reality series, The Road to Knoxville, in which 18 scantily clad young women vie for the heart of divorced stuntman Johnny Knoxville. Officials there are struggling to control the spread of slut, which has already polluted the roadway and is spreading now down a hillside into residential areas. Let's go live to Onion News Network's Brian Scott, who's live on the scene. Brian, what's exactly going on out there?
Well, it's just horrible, Anna. The highway here was not pristine to begin with, but now it's covered in all of this orange-skinned slut. I've only been here an hour. I've already seen 4 three-way kisses and 6 tattoos with misspellings. Oh. And downwind, the stench of perfume and tequila mixed together is pretty difficult to stomach.
Well, sounds like quite a scene. Brian, I understand that the sluts had been loaded onto the bus in Huntington Beach early this morning. Is that right?
But that's where it began, yes. The sluts were being transported from a negligee-wearing rock climbing contest there to a girl-on-girl paintball match when the crash occurred. There's been speculation, in fact, the accident was actually caused by some slut leaking into the front cab on the vehicle and getting on the driver.
I see.
Now, the local fire department is just not equipped to handle something this toxic.
No,
the problem is that we're very close to the San Gabriel River, and officials are concerned that the sluts might go skinny dipping in it or think it's a hot tub and make out in it.
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
But we should say, too, that the crews, they're doing their best. They're just trying to keep these sluts contained with impromptu strip-offs and shooter contests in the ditch behind me.
Now, we've just gotten word that VH1 has issued a statement. It's on their website. It says they are fully committed to the safe handling of sluts.
Yes, but the EPA has urged VH1 to use perhaps a more diluted form of slut than this highly concentrated slut they use now.
Yeah, all sounds like good stuff, but I don't think VH1's going to ever go for that. Brian, stay safe out there and don't fuck any of those sluts.
All right, thank you.
So there's a little bit of VH1 breaking news from CNN. Better watch out if you're in downtown area. You don't want to catch that case of sickness. Oh, what a hoot. And there's actually a really it's messed up song. Nah, actually it's funny as fuck. You know, like I said, we play and do anything on this network. You know, this is just to get y'all's blood pumping and laughing like a motherfucker this morning. check this out. This is what happens when you get into a bad case of slut.
Lock eyes from across the room, down my drink while the rhythms boom. Take your hand and skip the names, no need here for the silly games. Make our way through the smoking crowd, the club is the sky and I'm on your cloud. Move in close as the lasers fly, our bodies touch and the angels cry. Leave this place, go back to yours, our lips first touch outside your doors. The whole night what we've got in store, whisper in my ear that you want some more and I jizz in my pants. This really never happens, you can take my word, I won't apologize, that's just absurd. Mainly your fault for the way that you dance and how I jizz in my pants. Don't tell your friends or I'll say you're a slut, plus it's your fault you were rubbing my butt. I'm very sensitive, some would say that's a plus. Now I'll go home and change. I need a few things from the grocery, do things alone now mostly. Left me heartbroken, not looking for love, surprise in my eyes when I looked above the checkout counter and I saw her face. My heart stood still, so did time and space. Never thought that I could feel real again, but the look in her eyes said I need a friend. She turned to me, that's when she said it, looked me dead in the face, asked cash or credit, and I jizzed in my pants. It's perfectly normal, nothing wrong with me, but we're going to need a clean up on aisle 3. And now I'm posed in an awkward stance because I jizzed in my pants. To be fair, you were flirting a lot, plus the way you bagged cans got me bothered and hot. Please stop acting like you're not impressed, one more thing I'm gonna pay by check. Last week, I saw a film, as I recall it was a horror film. Walked outside into the rain, checked my phone and saw you rang, and I jizzed in my pants. Speeding down the street when the red lights flash, need to get away, need to make a dash. A song comes on that reminds me of you, and I jizz in my pants. Next day, my alarm goes off and I jizz in my pants. Open my window and a breeze rolls in and I jizz in my pants. When Bruce Willis was dead at the end of Sixth Sense, I jizzed in my pants. I just ate a grape and I jizzed in my pants. I went jizzed okay, in my pants.
Seriously, you guys, can we? Okay.
I jizz right in my pants every time you're next to me. And when we're holding hands, it's like having sex to me. You say I'm premature, I just call it ecstasy. I wear a rubber at all times, it's a necessity.
Cause I jizz in my pants.
I jizz in my pants, I just in my pants, I jizz in my pants, I just in my pants.
Yes, I jizz in my pants.
And that's what happens whenever you get into a case of slut. You cannot control yourself anymore. That would be a messed up problem to have, though, in reality. Really? I mean, that is just, yeah, haha, funny.